It's always so exciting to sit alone and then waiting, is she coming or not?
I know, and I was here like turning, I was like, where's the notification? How do I come online? Always interesting, right?
So nice that we meet again, huh?
I know. I think it's really so amazing, like our connection, because, you know, for those people who don't know, we've never met in person. And no. I don't even know how we found each other in this Facebook world.
Yes.
But I think it's really crazy that now you're in love with the person that I actually know, because I've been in Morocco last year and I hosted a yoga retreat there and I met Omar.
I mean, so like, nice.
So really, I'm so happy for you. And, you know, I know it's just so amazing when you find love and you're like so full of sparks and, you know. And so I hope one day we meet in person too.
I'm sure we meet one day. And for me, it's also so nice because I don't know how many years ago, I'm following you since I think 2 or 3 years now on social media. And I've always liked a lot to feel the connection between you and Daniel, and it was always you feel for me very my English is not so perfect, but I will make it.
Of course you will make it.
You feel like I know you for years, you know, and then it's so nice, this connection. Yeah. So
perfect.
Because for me it was the last weeks, it was a very challenging and intense process. I don't know if you have been watching it, but I felt really drawn to share many things about my new love and how I experience it. And I was also posting pictures and writing about it because I really felt deep in my heart that it is important to do it. And yeah, therefore we also reconnected again, we two.
Yes, and you know, and it's the same. I totally hear you because sometimes I feel also, wow, this is so private and I should just keep it to myself. But then I also feel like, you know, I really need to share it because I know it, like, it needs to inspire other people, because I've been many times in my life not in a happy relationship and I was like, it's never gonna happen, I'm never gonna meet that person. And instead of looking at all the people that were struggling like me, there were like maybe 2-3 people that like were living the kind of relationship that I was longing for. And I was really happy that they shared about it. And I would ask them, like, tell me, what's your secret? How did you make it work? And of course, it's not all like pink clouds. But, you know, so and that I always remember. And it's like, you know, I need to share this. And whoever gets annoyed, sometimes people even say, it's too much. Stop posting all these happy pictures because, you know, I'm not in this space. And like, it really gets me upset. And I'm like, really? Like, because I don't mean it from a place of like, wow, I have what you don't have or anything like that. It's really about like, we can all do this. There's nothing special about me that I created this, you know, but like there are certain things that clicked in my life. And a lot of it was really people sharing with me how they were managing and navigating through this challenge of love. You know, it is not easy.
I feel the same. I feel it is so important to share it, not from a point of, I'm so good and that, but from a point of sharing the journey to get what is your deepest desire, and this process to share is very important, because I think from outside it sometimes look okay for me. Now I'm traveling a lot and people sometimes give me the feedback, oh yeah, you have everything and for you it's easy, and this is not true. Sometimes it was such a deep process for years, and you know this, and this is so important to share it, and also to share the steps and the golden keys.
Absolutely.
What is for you, what are the most important keys that helped you to open up this fulfilling relationship in your life?
I think the main key was really to show up for myself first, you know, because I know previously I was always, you know, kind of not desperate, but definitely always like, you know, having this vision, but making a lot of compromises because I rather wanted to be with somebody than being alone or like hold on to something, even though it wasn't really working anymore, until I really realized that's not going to make me happy. And I'm never going to find that person that's going to fill my own holes or fill my needs. And I know this is something we all know, and it's not like you turn on a switch and you're like, okay, now I'm fine, you know, but that's when, like, you know, when you realize that, and I believe that for me was the practice of yoga and the community of yoga that always kept encouraging me to keep searching, keep trusting yourself, keep looking at your stuff and keep finding tools to work through your own issues, and then everything will shift. So that I really realized, yeah, once you do the work, and I know you do it, and that's maybe why now this also came to your life, once you start looking at yourself and not looking for happiness outside and blaming other people for your unhappiness, then all of a sudden, the funny thing is you get to a point where you're like, I actually don't really look for a relationship, you know? Yeah. So like after all these years of like, could he be the one? Could he be the one? I was like, I'm actually enjoying my life by myself. And I had planned all these trips. I wanted to go to Bali and here and there, just having a good time with myself. And that's when I met Daniel. And then it was like, what? Like, I'm not really looking for a relationship right now. And he was in the same space. And he was like, me neither. But then we were having fun together. And then, you know, but it was so different from the beginning, from every other relationship I had before, where it was really this like kind of like, what can I get from you, or what can you give me? And you know, this, it was really just pure like, I'm here, you're here, you know, we're very different people, Daniel and I, but it was, you know, it was never from a place of like, I want you to change for me or to do anything for me. So I think really the first step is to, to show up for yourself, take responsibility for yourself. And like you were talking about triggers, like become aware of like, what are your triggers and why? Why do you keep repeating? Why do you keep be attracted to the same kind of person? You know, I was always very attracted to people that were kind of like the mysterious guys and unavailable. And then I would always be like, I need to show them I can make them happy. Forget it, it's not going to work, you know. You know, and then, and I don't know, somehow I shifted that pattern. And I also worked with a relationship coach because I really like just needed to figure out what it was also that I, you know, and I think for me, it was coming also from this, like not good enough and like the conditioning of like, I have to be in a relationship no matter what and all this kind of stuff, you know?
Yes, I think this is the most important point. Is it okay when I dive in?
Yeah, totally.
This, to do the work, you know, as you mentioned, to fill the hole inside of yourself. And first of all, to feel it, huh? To realize really that you're searching something outside, which should be found inside, which should be filled inside. For me, this was maybe the most tough part of it. To stop searching outside, stand still and look to myself. And feel this hole and feel this pain and this neediness and this, like this feeling I'm missing something or I'm not good enough, you know, and to really face these parts of myself. And I did long walks in the nature and I cried a lot and also, but really to get in touch with myself on a much deeper level and to feel this old pain wherever it comes. Yeah, this is not so important, but just to face and to how do you say it, Dagmar? To look at yourself.
To look at yourself.
Yeah. And then this healing process starts, huh? And then you get, you start to feel a deep connection with yourself and to live a fulfilled life just with yourself.
Yeah, and then I think you can make the shift of like, okay, so now I know where I'm coming from. Next step, where do I want to go? And I really, with my coach back then, we made a lot of lists of like, really, again and again, like, what do I want? You know, and I was even visualizing things that some part of me was like, you cannot ask for that. That's too much to ask for, you know? And then I was like, oh, I'm going to put it anyway, you know? And I remember my coach, she would always say to me, ask for anything. Don't worry about how you're going to get there. Leave that up to the universe because the universe works in magical ways. And I was like, okay. So I kept making my lists and like revising my lists. And I think that's a very important process, if especially if you tend to be a person like I was, to, you know, think you have to make a lot of compromises and have, you know, I had a problem really like speaking up for myself or really honoring my own needs because, you know, my ex-boyfriend, for example, he was, you know, very much into partying. And when I was more into yoga, you know, I really feel like there was such a different frequency or energy. And then I would talk to my friends and they'd be like, oh, come on, just be tolerant. And then I would beat myself up and be like, just be tolerant, just be tolerant. And meanwhile, there was like energetically, like it really like gave me this like tension in my chest, in my heart, you know, because it was kind of like I was clipping my own wings just to be tolerant. which in the end didn't work out anyway. And that's the second thing. It's like once you, you know, I think once you become really clear of what it is that you need or what kind of energy you need, you know, and it's not about like this is good and this is bad, you know, I mean, people can do whatever they want, but I think it's really empowering to ask yourself what it is that you really, really find is a non-negotiable in any relationship and then stick to that, you know, because I think that's... Yeah.
And that you feel what is really important for my life, you know, what do I really want to live? Yeah. Because it's very interesting, as you mentioned this now, I realized that the point where my energy changed was the point where I said no to the man before, you know, I was in contact with. Because it was like I was feeling it is not, it feels not good how he's treating me, and like you mentioned it, I put down my energy to fit in, and I felt it is not serving me. And then I just made a strong no, this is finished, yeah? And this is the moment where the magic started to happen, where my energy shifted and totally new things came to my life very fast.
Yeah, because a no to somebody else is a yes to yourself.
Yes.
And that is super empowering. And, you know, and we're always so scared to say no, but it's like, wow, every time you say yes, it's like, yes, I stood up for myself and that feels good. And that brings you also in this energy. And it's not about being selfish and like pushing people away, but it's really just being clear of like, you know, and finding that clarity again to me comes through the yoga and everything that is yoga. You know, it's like, okay, I want to have that clarity, because before I was always like, do I want this or do I want this, this, this? I was all the time like in between. Do I want to end the relationship? Do I want to go on? Mm-hmm. And it's just, it's exhausting, you know. But then doing the work with yourself and finding the clarity, it's like, that's all of a sudden, you know, okay, I'm on the path. And then, you know, and then you meet other people that like, and you like realize, oh, I'm starting to attract different people into my life. And you're like, and you keep going. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, there's actually interesting new people coming into my life. Yeah. And you feel the shift and, you know.
Yeah. This is very, very interesting to watch this. Yeah. And as you say, I feel this no is sometimes really, for me, it is a very interesting practice. And it is such an important sign also for the universe, you know. And it's just, you give out very clear, this is what I want and this is what I not want. And then the universe can start to serve us, you know, and because we are ready. And for me, it was, I don't know how you experienced it, Dagmar, but for me, it was like the moment when it arrived, you know, and I was feeling, okay, there is a man which is available and he's really here. Ooh, it brought up a lot in my system.
Oof. Ooh. Me too. I like wanted to run away because that was also, then I realized that actually being attracted to men that are unavailable was helping me so much myself for like, you know, and then Daniel, he was this person that just showed up and he was like, the moment, I mean, we knew each other for years, but we never were really connected. And the moment that then we connected and he was like so real and so honest and saying like, you know, I always felt this connection with you. I was like, what? Like which connection? You know, and then like I had all these red lights go on. But luckily he was just so real. And he just, you know, he helped me to move through all these like moments of freak out. And he just had space for me because he was just like, what's going on with you? And because I had done the work with this woman, I actually realized that that was what was going to happen, what was happening. And that's another exciting thing to share, because I remember also she said to me, you know, we're always in this hope cycle. We have experiences and we kind of make a belief, like things that happened to me in my life that were not good experiences then led to thinking anytime I surrender myself, somebody's going to knock me over. But you keep hoping one day this person is going to come and everything's going to be different. So your whole body is in this hope cycle. Mm-hmm. So then the moment this person comes, your body freaks out, because if you're not going to hope for that person to come anymore, what are you going to hope for? Yeah. And she said, so your whole system wants to be in this like hope cycle. Your whole system is going to hold on to it and it's going to freak out. And that's exactly what happened to me. And I was sitting there and I was really like shivering. And I was watching, I was like, wow, like, you know, but then I remembered, okay, this is the shift, this is the breakthrough, I just have to stick to it, you know?
Yeah.
And then Danny would just like sit there and be like, what's going on? Why are you shivering? And I was just like, you know, and then I was verbalizing and I said, you know, I actually really realized I'm like freaking out. I'm like, I have such a longing to let myself go, and I'm so scared of it, you know. And he'd be like, okay, let's just like sit here and breathe together, you know. And I was just like, what? He's not getting up and running away,
running,
you know. So thinking like I'm a freak or whatever. But that again was so beautiful, because it's like I could be so like, and I was really like, I was like, if he doesn't take me the way I am, that's fine. That's, you know, he can go anytime.
Yeah.
And interestingly enough, he stayed, and he was just like curious, like what was going on with me, you know. So, yeah,
this is
the shift.
This is very, very interesting. This moment, yeah, for me too, because I realized that this always taking men, which were on an emotional level, I say, kind of unavailable, that now this big change brings me back to look at me and to feel my big fear of being enough. And of being lovable, and of sharing my, for me, it's such a learning at the moment to share my love and my trust, and to show up with this. And then there comes such a big fear inside of me. And it's like you say, the system freaks out, but it's so beautiful because Oma is just watching me. And why are you running now? Just sit and be here.
Exactly.
And I get really crazy sometimes, but then I stay. And
it's the same,
a deep healing process.
That's beautiful. I remember him being like that because, you know, maybe you heard that we got into a rainstorm and sandstorm on the cameras, and Omar was just guiding the cameras, and we were all freaking out. And he was just like, why are you guys freaking out? So very good. Like, no matter, it's symbolic, no matter what sandstorm is going to hit you, you know, when you want to run away, he'll be like, Karen, have a little tea. Why you want to run away? Very good. So I suggest you stay. It's worth staying. Yes. And that's another thing, you know, it's like, I'm such a runaway person whenever things get challenging, and I really learned to stay.
Yes.
And sometimes it's still challenging for me, but it's so worth it. It's so beautiful to stay.
I feel the same. It's so such a big commitment, huh?
Mm-hmm.
For yourself, huh?
Mm-hmm. But it's rewarding, you know, and like when you do yin yoga, that's all it's all about staying in the whatever happens on your mat. So again, I can always just relate it to yoga because that's my practice, but but I feel it helps, you know. And it's not that ever goes away. So now I'm with Daniel 10 years. I still have my moments of wanting to run away.
You still have that one?
Oh, absolutely. But it feels way different because now it's just really like, it's like, you know, a little impulse of like noticing my pattern of like, okay, now I just want to run away and be like, now I tell myself, you stay, you know what to do to stay, and I stay, you know? So, yeah, I think the challenge, you know, like the challenge never ends, and especially the challenge to me to really stick to myself, you know, like we wrote a little bit about that, and that's something to share maybe when you continue in your relationship. I think it's so important not to give up yourself. And that's another thing I used to do with my compromises, and I tend to just merge into the other person. Mm-hmm. And with Daniel, he's such a strong person too. In the beginning, you're in love, like now you are, and you just want to do everything together and melt everything together and like be together every minute. But luckily, we are both very like independent people. So it was very clear from the beginning also that we really need to make an effort to have time to ourselves. And he's really good in doing that because he has a lot of hobbies. He goes motorbiking and biking with, you know, and he just takes off for a couple hours. But that's me, perfect. I'm much more like, you know, I have a much harder time to really find my own things to do or to take off, you know. And I have to constantly remind myself. And I think this is super important that we don't have to share everything together, you know, that like in the beginning, you know, he loves to go hiking in the mountains. I'm afraid of heights. And those things were actually challenges for us. Like we would go hiking and I would be like, I want to go all the way up to the mountaintop where the snow is. And we would go up there and I'd be like, and then like, you know, and then he would be like, what's going on? Like, and he's like, that's so sad. We're never going to be able to experience that together because he cannot take me to the mountaintops because I'll freak out. And there was really a moment of sadness of like, oh, we're never going to be able to do this together. And then it's like, Well, we don't have to. If he needs to go up to the mountains and climb, you know, he has to do it with his friends. Yeah. I love to go to cities. He doesn't like cities at all. So now I go to cities by myself. And it's okay, you know. So we have to, so after this whole, like, do everything together, you know, then you have to find, you know, your, like, your balance of doing things together, but sticking to your own rules, to your own, like, space, you know. So
I think this is very important, But for me, it's also already now important, you know.
I'm totally.
Because if I'm also a person, I feel always everybody around me very strong. And I feel other people sometimes like myself. I feel the emotions and I need to go out sometimes and just reconnect with myself. I think this is maybe the red line for our talk today. Yeah? This always to reconnect with yourself and then go back to the connection.
Yeah, it's like a dance. I think dance is a beautiful image, you know, because you like dance together, you like go out and you find each other together as long as you find your flow, you know, and and it's easy to like some, if you feel stuck, then it's very difficult, but you know, but you can create it if you know that that's a non-negotiable for you, then you can always create that. And I think the sooner you create that, the more it's going to be understood. Like I have friends, for example, like Daniel and I, we built our house 2 years ago, our new house, and we created two separate bedrooms, which I would have never thought ever that, you know, that I would be living in two separate bedrooms. But it's really beautiful because the concept was from the beginning, I'm going to have my room and he's going to have his room. And we love it because now I go visit him in his energy, because the rest of the house is kind of our energy. But like in the beginning, you meet a person and you go to their house, you visit them. I love it. And then you go and you like kind of you treat also the whole space with a little more respect. You know, like if stuff is lying on the floor, you don't say anything because it's not your room. So you like, you know, and it's actually been really, really, really great. But the good thing is that we, you know, we made the idea from the beginning and we were clear on it. Like in my previous house, it was more like my house and he was living there. And then if one of us would have been like, oh, today I'll go sleep on the couch, it would have felt like, what? Why are you sleeping on the couch? You're abandoning me, you know? But now if you like created, like if you know that that's something you need, and if you create it from the beginning, then it has a different energy, because then it's something like, we love it, you know. So now we sometimes sleep together, then we sleep in my room, we sleep in his room, or we sleep separate and we come in the morning, whoever wakes up first comes over. It's so nice. And it helps with a lot of issues that we usually would have because we have different rhythms, you know. Or it would take me, you know, I wouldn't sit in the morning to meditate because, you know, we're lying in bed together and it's like, oh, I'd rather cuddle instead of doing my meditation, you know.
Yes.
So now it's like, you know, I'll do my meditation and then I'll walk over, you know, so it's it's nice, you know.
I found the same for me because I like so much to jump up in the morning and start with some practice and to do my, I love to do my work in the early morning time. And Omar really likes to be in the morning very slowly coming up. And in the first weeks, it was making me really crazy, yeah. And then, like you say, and then I was thinking, Karin, what are you doing here? Yeah, why you not just get up, do your things, and then later come back? And this is, I feel this is so important, not to get lost totally, to dive into a deep connection together, but then go also out and do what is important for you in your life and what serves you, you know, to feel yourself very deep, yeah?
And I think also it helps to understand or have like less expectations of the other person too. Like it's something that I really love about Daniel and me. Like it's really the first time I'm in a relationship where there's really nothing I want to change about Daniel. And it's not that he doesn't bother me sometimes or that there's nothing that annoys me, but I don't know, somehow we really manage to hold this space. And it's like, I want him to really be happy, seriously do anything he needs to do to be happy in a good space, because I know then he's also in a good space for me. And and if I have my own struggles, I also don't, you know, I don't even blame him for that, or it's, you know, it's like I know sometimes I'll just have to do my own thing, to find my own way out of there, you know. And and that is really beautiful. I really also feel from him like he loves me the way I am. He doesn't want to change me, and there's none of this like, but you did that I had before of like, you know, wanting to change somebody or convince somebody to do something you love, you know, all this, you know. But yeah, it takes a lot of, I mean, it, you know, it takes a lot of awareness, I think, a lot of like really consciously like making the effort to talk about it, to share what you need, and that's something we women are a little easier with, I'd say.
But it's very interesting, that point you mentioned, Dagmar. What do you think, what opens up this inside of you and inside of you both to let the other be how he is and to respect it fully and to feel the love and the you are like you are, and I am responsible for my things. And if you trigger me, it's my job. This is what I feel. What helps you in the on a daily basis? You are together now 10 years. Do you have some ideas? What are the
my practice and just like knowing that like anytime I start nagging on him, he's gonna run away and he's just gonna be like, "What do you want?" You know. And I know that if I take care of myself, he'll come anyway. You know, it's just a different energy. And it's the same for me. I know when he's grumpy or something, I can be there and offer to hold space for him. But I know it's not going to be the same as if he gets on his bike and he goes for a bike ride and he'll come back. And then, you know, and even like, you know, I'm very much a person like, we need to talk, you know, and he doesn't like it at all. And now I've learned, okay, if we need to talk, then we need to go for a walk or something on the beach and then in nature, or we need to sit under a tree, you know, if I'm going to be pushing and right away, if something happens to like, so it's really more like, watching, observing and learning and also understanding not everybody needs the same, you know, like watching him, how he handles it and how he just has his hobbies that like he, you know, if he's upset, he gets on the bike and he goes. I don't have that tool. So I'm much more like, well, what do I do when I'm upset? And then it's like when I'm upset, I need to either sit by myself and write, or I need to go and find a girlfriend that I can talk with, you know, and just like something like that. So, and him being so independent has really taught me or given me also the freedom to also be so independent. So, you know, I think if I would have a partner who would be more attached to me in that sense, it would be more difficult for me. But he's a very free spirit, and that shows me, I can, same rights for everybody, right? So I can also be free and independent and do what I need to do. So we learn from each other, you know. So he probably has learned to be a little bit more open to communication because he realizes I need that. And I've learned from him showing that he's willing to learn. I've also learned to just let it be a little bit more and let him take off first. And I'll know, I trust when he comes back, we'll find our moment and our like our dance, you know.
Yes.
Sounds so I think
beautiful, because you get to trust each other more and more. If you have the experience, he just needs to go out and then he will come back, and then it's time to, for example, to find a way. I think also this is very important, this point of view that you see life as a big experience where you can learn in every moment, and that every person is coming is a beautiful teacher. This helps me a lot at the moment, because sometimes I was many years hoping to have such a beautiful relationship and such a depth together. And now it's really forcing me sometimes and really bringing me very fast to my borders, you know, and to my, And then, but it helps me a lot to feel it's such a gift if I open up for the learnings in every moment, because they are so huge, you know. Because in our situation, Omar and me, we are in different cultures raised, and he is also very introverted, and I am like you, I need a lot to talk and then to so it's very important, and from the language it's also not so perfect fitting, so it's we are forced to feel each other very strong behind the words, you know, and to find a way to reconnect with each other without talking. And this is for me sometimes a little bit tough, but then in the end it's so beautiful to walk together and in the moment, in the first moment, I feel sometimes really bored because I like to talk, you know, about learnings and energy and transformation. And then this is not possible. But then when we walk together and I feel his energy and his presence beside me, and then we reconnect and it's on another level and it's very interesting. And it feels the same like you explain it, or like you, the picture like you show me, to feel the other person and to find a very unique dance together. Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I totally agree, because Dan is very much like that too. And it really needed me. But I think also the polarity of men and women, which is something, you know, like I know before I always was like, you know, I was always like, you know, taking care of my own business, being independent. And I know that also put men off, because, you know, then I had men that at some point I also felt like I cannot really trust them, or but I keep doing my own stuff. So I never really fully surrendered. And then Daniel is a person who's very like physical, gets a lot of things done, is really a person who like does what he says, which was so important to me, that like he sticks to, like if he shows up, he shows up 100%.
Yeah.
And that really allowed me also to like surrender into that and be much more feminine. And so there's also this beautiful dance of like feminine and masculine, in a sense that like I can really like, yeah, there's certain things I don't even try to do. I just, you know, like I just totally follow him. And that's the same with nature, because I've learned so much the connection to nature through him, which is such a gift, because I would never go by myself hiking 4 hours in the mountains, like, you know, and now with him I do. And I actually like, I love it, you know, because just the way he sees nature and the way he feels it, and exactly the same thing, to just sit somewhere by the river on the mountain without talking, just holding, it's just so like, oh, it feels so good, you know.
Yeah.
And then the other way around, I'm really excited about, like, you know, design, and, you know, get inspired when I go to cities. And then, like, you know, and it's clear, if we go to cities, I'm in charge. He just follows me. And he's always a little like, really, do we need to go to the city and go to a museum and go watch a movie? And then he loves it. He dives in and he also surrenders, you know, and he's like, okay, actually, that was really nice to see the movie, or to have dinner with friends, you know.
Yeah.
So it's like, you have to, it's beautiful also if you're not absolutely the same, and to cherish and respect that, you know, that like the being different, even though if it means that certain things we can't do together, so then I'll do it with somebody else. Yeah. You know?
And I want to go back to this point you mentioned. It's very important also for me, female and male, this masculine and female part, because I think we are both the same. We are very, tough woman, huh? We do so many things. And for me, it's really Omar is the first man who really, where I feel I can surrender. It's so interesting, and it's so beautiful for me, because I experience my female side on a much deeper level than ever before. Because he's so strong in this masculine power, this pure awareness, you know, this really, like you say it. And this is such a big gift for me, because then I can relax, and then I can just, give up doing, checking everything.
Exactly. No, it's beautiful when you, to me too, I always say, like, Daniel to me is like the rock in my back, you know. And even like when we do our retreats together, first he was always like, oh, I'm just going to be the hung player. I'll just show up and play the hung. I was like, no. You have way too much to share, not to show up fully and be there. And so he had to really learn also from, like, you know, but to me, just knowing he's there is so nice for me too, because I feel like, okay, if anything, you know, he's in my back, and he'll be, you know, holding me, you know. And that it, and we have to, as women, also like learn to like soften and surrender into that. And that again, for me, is the yoga, you know. So like, just is this constant reminder, we cannot just push through life. I mean, we're both European, so that's how we learn. It's like, okay, you just find your way, and you don't need a man. You can do this by yourself.
You can do everything alone. Huh?
Exactly. And we can, you know, and it's beautiful, and it's great what we've created. But then it's also so nice to share, and it's so nice to sometimes just like, sit by the river and do nothing, yes. sit in the desert and let somebody else be in charge and allow yes. that to happen. And I think for a man, like Daniel said in the beginning, I also remember he was like, it's so nice to have a woman who allows me to take care of mm-hmm. her, because a lot of women, he also said, like, don't really, you know, trust enough to like let go or surrender. Mm-hmm. And so there's always a little bit of this, like, you know, like,
resistance and, yeah.
yeah, or like, you know, the polarity doesn't really fully work. And it doesn't mean that the woman is always the feminine and the man is always the masculine,
no.
but.
Yeah.
But I think it works perfectly if, you know, if it's very clear who's in charge of what. Like, you know, I book all our travels and retreats and stuff like that. He would never even deal with it, you know. But he built a house and, you know, and he was like, yes. he's taking care of all these things. And, like, he takes me, like I said, you know. So it's really, we found a really nice yeah. flow of, like, who's in charge for what. And that's maybe yeah. another tip for relationships that's good, you know, to be really clear of, like, you know, what is everybody's strength and weakness, and like mm-hmm. the things that I'm not good at, why would I try to compete with him doing yeah. it? Like, why don't I just let him do it? Great. And be like, thank you so much. Finally, somebody else is doing it. Great. You know, and then yeah. the same for him, you know. So, yeah. yeah.
This is beautiful, yeah. And for me, I realized that I was in many experiences before, I was fighting, you know, like, who is the stronger, who is the, I wanted always to control. And this mm-hmm. is such, for me, such an important piece of experience, yeah, to really trust somebody so deeply, to let yourself fall into this experience. And this is such a game changer for me, because of course it's also challenging, but it's also such a beautiful experience to feel you trust, and then there is ground, you know, where you land together somehow.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
for me this is, yeah.
Well, enjoy it. It's really special. It's really beautiful when that happens, absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. And it's nice, because I also even feel when that happens, it gets to the point for me, for the first time, that I really trust, in the sense that, like, I don't even worry he's going to leave me or any yeah. of these things, you know. It's like, I don't know, it's just really, it's such a beautiful, like, there's so much freedom and respect for each other that I also know we're not going to, like, ruin this for something yeah. crazy or whatever. But on the other hand, I'm also aware, who knows if we're going to be together forever. It doesn't matter, because right mm. now this is what it is. We're growing yeah. together. We're not growing apart from each other. We have our challenges. Sometimes we're a little bit more disconnected, then we find each other again. Yeah. And as long as we always find each other again, which always happens in those moments where, you know, we do our own thing and, like, we stand up for ourselves,
yeah.
then it's like, you know, it's yeah. beautiful. And then we find each other again.
And I think, Dagmar, I'm very happy you mentioned it now. It's such a big golden key also, this commitment, you know. I say yes to you, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I really go into this with full commitment and face what is coming up. And I will learn with it and I will grow with it. But I'm here, you know. And
mm-hmm.
This feels for me, at the moment, is one of my most important learnings for a relationship, for life
mm-hmm.
relationship, yeah. Just really to find this, or to come to this decision inside of you, I am here and I stay.
That's great, yeah.
For yourself?
Absolutely, absolutely. I have like some weird echo now. Are we still good?
I don't know. I have many messages here. I will look now, Dagmar.
Okay, because I also think I need to, like, plug my phone in because
it.
I got the message, like, I got low battery, so let's
maybe this is the problem. I read it, what is written.
Okay
Alexandra is writing, I relate. I have been experiencing fear around really truly relying on another, that they will be able to support me too and show up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is really such a, I feel it is an experience which is really bringing up a lot of fear to surrender to another person and really to trust on a deep level.
That's so, I have
a safe space, huh?
Yeah, so I have a total echo. This is so weird. I hear everything you say and then I hear it again. Are we
okay.
like,
Wait,
I'm confused
I
now.
Ask, how is it for the, do you hear echo when you are listening to us? Is it still Dagmar?
This is very bizarre because I basically hear now, like, and it keeps repeating like the things you said a minute ago.
Okay.
I don't know, how did that happen?
Nobody is writing us, so I don't know. Maybe it's a point of stopping it, you hear me?
I hear you, yes, but like, but I hear you like, and myself in the background, that's crazy.
I hear you very well, Dagmar, but maybe we leave it now if it's such a bad
Okay.
Wait, one is writing? No, no, what does it mean? Do you hear us? It sounds clear, Dagmar, but if you don't hear it, it's not nice for you.
No, I still, yeah, no, I still, but it just started like a minute ago. I don't know why.
Yeah, maybe the internet is bad.
Yeah, but you know what we can do is also if, since now I hear myself again. So maybe what we do is like ask people to leave comments and if they have questions, we'll just answer them in the comments. And
yes, we do this. Because Dagmar has a bad internet connection or Karin, I don't know, I'm in Morocco, Dagmar is in Costa Rica, something is happening. So yes, leave the in the comments if you have something to share with us or questions and we will take a look later, Dagmar, huh?
Exactly. And then we'll continue the conversation in 5 years. See where
and
we
maybe
are.
Maybe we make a retreat together or something. We will see.
Exactly. Okay, good.
Have a nice time. Bye.
Okay, you too. Say hello to Omar. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Bye. Bye.